It is hard to beat spending your Christmas in paradise, and this is about as close as you're going to get. Aloha Stadium in Honolulu, Hawaii. Even Santa Claus is here on Christmas Day, and Frosty the Snowman hasn't melted yet. We're getting set for the Jeep Eagle Aloha Bowl between UCLA and Kansas. Merry Christmas, everyone. I'm Terry Gannon. You know, when you wake up on Christmas Day, you never quite know what you're going to get in those presents. Just a few minutes ago, the Kansas Jayhawks received a present that I'm sure shocked them with a breaking story down in the field that sent it down to Dean Blevins. Dean?
Well, Terry, it is a big story, big for both the University of Kansas and the University of Georgia. Glenn Mason told me minutes ago he is staying at the University of Kansas and reneging on his taking the job at the University of Georgia. It was a tough decision for Glenn, one he was never totally comfortable with, and it is something that was hard for him to decide upon, but he is definitely staying at the University of Kansas. One reason, perhaps, I think he considers himself more of a northern guy. Coaching in the Deep South may have been a major transition for him, so that will not only be a factor for those two schools, obviously, in the future, but in this game here today. Glenn Mason staying at the University of Kansas.
Well, I think that's such a big story all week long, and as Tim Brandt joins me right now, Timmy, you wonder what kind of an effect this has on everyone. What are your thoughts?
Well, let's break this down, Terry. First of all, for Georgia, now the Bulldogs are left in limbo. They don't know what they're going to do for a head coach. So that is critical now for the recruiting process and for them now going out and finding another head coach. Critical. And Georgia, by the way, is going to be loaded next year with talent. Yeah. Now, as far as Kansas is concerned, you look at Mike Hankowitz, you look at Golden Rule, the offensive and defensive coordinators. These are two guys that have worked very hard at their profession, and they thought that they would have an opportunity to get the head coaching job in Kansas, one or the other. And so now they are going to lose out on an opportunity they thought they had. Right. Mixed emotions, I'm sure. I'm sure they're glad to have Glenn back, but at the same time, mixed emotions because they now lose an opportunity as a head coach. Now, as far as Kansas recruiting, I know there are 11 recruits that Kansas wanted very badly that were ready to commit, but they were waiting to see what would happen with the head coaching situation. Now, those 11 recruits will probably sign with Kansas because Glenn Mason's going to return. However, do you say, wait a minute, this coach may leave at any time. He's wishy-washy. I think in the long run, this will hurt Glenn Mason if he ever wants to leave again. People will look at this, the athletic directors, chancellors, presidents will look at this and say, wait a minute, he accepted a job once and then at the 11th hour backed out and stayed. So there's a lot of questions and a lot of scenarios.
A big surprise earlier in the week when he took the job. In fact, he wasn't able to break the story to his team. Golden Pat Rule had to do that as Glenn Mason flew down to Georgia to accept the head coaching job. Not only the coordinators right now, but also the other assistant coaches, you know, wondering if they were going to go to Georgia perhaps with the head coach Glenn Mason. What do they do now?
I'm positive right now in Georgia they are shocked. I know the fans don't know. They're hearing it for the first time. Dean Blevins breaking a story that I know just moments ago. I spoke to the Kansas front office, and those people up in the office say, we have no comment. Let Glenn Mason have it at the press conference after the game, and he'll address it. That's it.
Well, they go back to the chalkboard down in Athens, Georgia, and they go back to work. Glenn Mason does here at the Jeep Eagle Aloha Bowl. UCLA and Kansas coming up next on ABC Sports. They're getting in the spirit here, and the two head coaches at midfield talking things over. Let's go back to Roger Twybo.
Well, thanks, guys. You know, that's not unprecedented in Kansas history. Larry Brown at one time was going to go out to UCLA and kind of change his mind as when he was the basketball coach at Kansas. So, you know, there's a lot of good things out there in the heartland of America, Brian. And so that's a big story. Glenn Mason staying with the Jayhawks. And right now, let's check in with Lewis Johnson. Lewis.
Okay. Coach Alvarez, it was not a cakewalk, but your defense definitely played very strong.
The kids, you know, we talked to them about playing in a one-on-one situation, and obviously our kids won that one-on-one situation. I was real proud. They played hard, and I thought they really got closer together as the week went on and had fun with each other.
I guess it really shows the class and the experience that these guys have to be able to come in without knowing the plays and to sort of learn a whole new style of play and to be able to put that all together in a very solid football game.
Right? Really. We said right off after the first day of practice, we were very impressed with the character of the young men. I mean, they're willing souls. Anything that we wanted to do, they did and wanted more. We'd call practice off. They wanted to go practice more. So it does. It says a lot about their character. They love to play the game, and that's what it's all about.
Coach Alvarez, Merry Christmas.
Thank you very much, and Merry Christmas to all those people back up there in Wisconsin.
Well, Barry Alvarez looking for better things as the coaches who come down here usually, Brian, have gone through a tough year where they haven't been invited to a bowl game. But, of course, Barry Alvarez has done a wonderful job up in Wisconsin. He had a couple of his seniors here today, and Of course, those guys just, work doesn't stop. They just go right back to the recruiting process. And while we got a moment, let's go back down to Lewis.
Thanks, Roger. Steve, it was sort of a tough game. You know, you don't like to come in and lose, but talk about some of the things that you did well today.
Well, I think I showed some mobility today. Made a nice few throws, scrambling out of the pocket. And, you know, I just came out here to have fun. You know, there was some pressure, but as a quarterback, you expect that. I think I showed my toughness. I kept getting back up and competing, and I think that's a big thing for me.
Give the folks at home a sense, an idea of what will be happening with you between now and the combine and then when you wait for those phone calls on the draft.
Right. Well, you know, I got the Senior Bowl down here in Mobile in a few weeks, and I'm just going to go back to South Carolina and prepare. Got to work hard and get back in some football shape and get ready for the combine. You know, it's time for me to, you know, work out and really focus. This is my second season. You know, you sort of have the time when you're on the field and time to get in the weight room and start working out. So I got a lot ahead of me.
Okay, guy. Merry Christmas to you and Happy New Year.
Yeah, I'd just like to say hello to everybody in Altoona, PA.
Okay, Roger, back upstairs. A lot of good quarterbacks come out of the state of Pennsylvania, and there's one more. And coming up next, the Chief Eagle Aloha Bowl, the big story. Glenn Mason's going to stay at Kansas. Far as we know, Terry Donahue's leaving UCLA. And the Dallas Cowboys and the Arizona Cardinals coming up on ABC's Monday Night Football win. The Cowboys go all the way through with home field advantage. And once again, the Jeep Eagle Aloha Bowl coming up next. For Lewis Johnson and Brian Holloway, I'm Roger Twibel. Merry Christmas, everybody, from Montgomery.
With a show this provocative, this explosive, this intriguing, there's only one thing I can tell you. Mondays are murder. Stephen Bochco's Murder One, Mondays at 10, 9 Central, starting January 8th on ABC.
Did you know that there's a health plan right in your neighborhood whose doctors not only screen you for high-risk conditions, if they find something, the health plan can assign a nurse to coordinate your care?
Hi, it's Denise from FHP. How are you doing?
Right. It's FHP. A different kind of health plan. It's like a partnership between you and FHP and your doctor. And it's here now at FHP, your health partner for life.
Wall-to-wall clearance. Nothing held back this Tuesday, 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. 12 hours only. Up to 70% off. It's Sun Valley Waterbed's year-end liquidation. Markdowns of up to 70%. Plus, pay no interest and make no payments till July at Sun Valley Waterbeds.
First came the Innerspring mattress, later the waterbed. Now, the best of both, the StrataBed. Perfect in any bedroom, perfect in your bedroom.
Strata mattresses available exclusively at Sun Valley Waterbeds.
There's holiday magic, and all through the land, when snowflakes are sliding, it's part of the plan.
Holiday memory? Well, it starts out kind of tragic. My first daughter was born 3 months premature, and spent that first Christmas in the hospital. So did we. But not a year later, everything was okay, and I'll never forget the look on her face when she got to open those presents.
Happy holiday from 7 New, and Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas from ABC Sports.
At the young age of 31, Terry Donahue rocketed to college football center stage. For 20 years, as players have come and gone, through more Pac-10 wins than any other coach in history, Donahue has remained a fixture. Spending his Christmas here in paradise, Terry tries to ride the wave to victory one last time. But waiting at the break is Kansas head coach Glenn Mason, who was to say aloha to his Jayhawks, but decided at the last minute not to walk away from Lawrence. And the surf is definitely up here in Honolulu, Hawaii, far from the cold and the wind and the snow. A gorgeous day for college football. With ABC Sports, college football is proud to present the 1995 Jeep Eagle Aloha Bowl, featuring the UCLA Bruins from the Pac-10 and the Kansas Jayhawks out of the Big 8 Conference. And hello, everyone. I'm Terry Gannon, along with Tim Brandt, my partner, and Merry Christmas to you and your family. Hope you're having a Happy holiday. Well, I'll tell you what, Jim, it has been an odd week all week long in terms of the atmosphere. Glenn Mason accepted the head coaching job at Georgia earlier in the week. Just moments ago, he told his team, no, he's staying in Lawrence to coach the Jayhawks. You have Terry Donahue, who is leaving after 20 years as a head coach at UCLA to become a broadcaster. What kind of effect does this have on the program, on the players today?
Merry Christmas to you and to all of yours. It has been wild and woolly. I will say this for Terry Donahue, that obviously will be a motivating factor for UCLA. For the Glenn Mason situation, it's a shock. I'm sure the folks in Athens are still trying to figure it out. They're probably hearing it right now for the very first time. Now Georgia in limbo without a coach, and that will be critical as far as recruiting is concerned for those down in Bulldog territory. I'm sure the Kansas kids now will be excited that their coach is going to stay. I think for the offensive and defensive coordinator, Mike Hankowitz and Golden Rule, these are two guys that thought maybe they had an opportunity now to become a head coach at Kansas. So they must have mixed emotions here. They're losing out on an opportunity, but they get their coach back. I think the Kansas kids will be excited. And for the recruits, I know there's 11 guys that right. They were ready to sign. I'm sure now this will be a boost for them and they'll come to Kansas.
You have to wonder, too, the question does come up. Dr. Bob Frederick, the AD at Kansas, stayed behind in Lawrence to search for a new coach. Does Glenn Mason still remain the head coach of the Kansas Jayhawks?
I think he does, obviously, and this has to be a commitment that he has already received, or he would not have made this announcement that he was going to stay at Kansas. I will say this, though. We've been with Glenn Mason all week here in Oahu, and he talked about moving on. He's been on radio programs. The folks from Athens, Georgia, the Atlanta Constitution, folks all throughout the Southeast Conference have been here in Hawaii following this story, looking forward to him joining the SEC, and now all of a sudden he turns. How will that affect his future? You have to look at him if you're going to hire him down the road and say, wait a minute, he backed out of a coaching job once. I like Glenn Mason. He's done a marvelous job at Kansas. But this is going to play havoc, I think, in his future.
Yeah, the last time Kansas had 9 wins in the season, 1968. So it's been a long time coming. He's taken him to 2 bowl games in the last 4 years. And at least right now, it looks like he is staying as the head coach of the Kansas Jayhawks. On the field, though, Timmy, the players, the guys who will actually play the game today.
This will be a fun game. You look at UCLA, you've got a lot of name players here, big stars, guys that are going to play at the next level. For instance, you've got the guy that won the Outland Trophy. You're looking at Jonathan Ogden, I think a first rounder yet to come, maybe one of the top 5. That's him circled, and here comes Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, 11 games over 100, over 2,000 yards for his career. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is special. On the other side, 2 outstanding running backs. You've got LT Levine, June Henley for Kansas. This is like a hammer and chisel. They keep banging at you. And then the quarterback, Mark Williams, he's got great mobility, 3rd leading rusher. He has escapability, could cause some problems for UCLA. This is going to be a fun game. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Not a bad place to hold it either here, huh? Honolulu, Hawaii for the Chief Eagle Aloha Bowl. Kansas taking on the UCLA Bruins. The last go-around for Terry Donahue as the head coach of UCLA. Stay with us.
Okay, now don't get Grandma too excited.
That's right. Poor dear is probably a bit weak.
She has been running on the same Duracell battery since
the Ice Age.
Wow. Those Duracell batteries sure do last.
The copper top. No battery is stronger, longer.
Where were you when your Sudafed quit?
Math finals. I could hardly breathe.
Epidac 24 won't quit. Where were you when your Sudafed quit?
Route 9. I totally clogged up.
Epidac 24 won't quit. While Sudafed dissolves immediately, one Epidac Steady Tab keeps releasing just the right amount of medicine at the right time for 24-hour congestion relief. So it just won't quit.
Mine didn't quit. Mine is Epidac 24.
The cold pill that just won't quit.
Well, it's been a tremendous week out here in Honolulu, and today's not bad either. 81 degrees here, 60 degrees and cloudy in L.A. And Lawrence, Kansas, very warm, 29 degrees and cloudy. Welcome once again, everyone. Terry Gannon along with Tim Brandt. Merry Christmas from Honolulu and Aloha Stadium. And we send it down to the third member of our crew, the former Oklahoma quarterback, Dean Blevins, who has a special guest. Dean?
Thank you, Terry. Merry Christmas to you and all our viewers out there. You know, we told you a half hour ago that Glenn Mason is staying at Kansas. Terry Donahue, you're not staying at UCLA. How are your emotions right now?
Well, this is a hard day for me. UCLA has been my life for 25 years, and it's a tough thing to do, but I've made my decision, and I've been the luckiest guy in the whole world. You know, I've coached at one of the great schools, had a great president, and it's been a wonderful thing for me. My heart's heavy. I'm sad, but I got one more game to go here, so let's see if we can get a win.
Terry, briefly, when you walked onto the field with your team for the last time before a game, I noticed you looked around, looked in the stands, and waved and gave thumbs up. I assume that was the wife and three daughters.
Well, my family's up there, and they're struggling, and I just wanted to tell them everything's okay, and I want to say hello to my family back home, Laguna Beach and up in Washington. Hi, guys. Merry Christmas.
Class act. Good luck today.
Thanks, Dave.
And we'll be talking later with Terry's wife and the kids. Back to you guys.
All right, Dean, thank you. And Terry Donahue, 20 years as the head coach, winning his coach in UCLA history, and he has done it with class. And I think that may be the big guy dropping in for the game this afternoon.
This guy's not that big, but I tell you, he's dropping in. That's one of the L's.
Whoa! He dropped all right, right at midfield.
He hit the target. I'm not sure he hit it with what he wanted to, though.
Well, the game ball has to be coming in at some point here, and we've got a number of elves in parachutes dropping in on Aloha Stadium. But just to make the point about Terry Donahue, 20 years, it has to be an emotional day today, Tim.
No question about that. I can tell him this as he comes into the broadcast booth and gets into our business. He'll be working with Jim Nance, one of my former partners. He's in good hands, and I'm sure, you know, he's a quality guy, Terry Donahue. He'll do a fine job.
Another elf about the 29-yard line, so about 21 yards off. That's it. Well, it's been a gorgeous week here in Honolulu. About 85 degrees and sunny every single day.
They call this paradise. There's no question about it. That is not an over-exaggeration. It is simply magnificent.
Well, it's been a full weekend. We're helping kick off an exciting week of bowl games here on ABC. But, of course, the NFL winding down and an exciting weekend all weekend long. And you'll get Saturday on ABC Sports, NFL wild card playoff doubleheader. The matchups are set now. The Dolphins taking on the Buffalo Bills in Buffalo. And then it's the Lions taking on the Eagles in Philadelphia. Coverage begins at noon Eastern Saturday here on ABC Sports.
And after all the elves have arrived, Sina finally makes his appearance to a standing ovation from the crowd that has arrived.
Is that a busy night? Now a busy day. Taking a little college football here in Hawaii today, though.
I think the players are saying, hey, Sina, we know you've had a busy night. Give us the ball. We want to play.
Been up in the air a while. And Glenn Mason, we talked about the emotion of Terry Donahue. Boy, I can't even fathom the emotions and what's going inside the head of Glenn Mason right now. All week long, you know, every day with a press conference talking about taking the head job at Georgia and what that means to his players and his staff. And now he decides to stay.
You know, last month I was out in Kansas, had a chance to visit with him and his community and his family, everybody entrenched in the community. He obviously didn't want to leave.
And Ed Russ, the general manager of Jeep Eagle, at midfield for the coin toss. The 14th Jeep Eagle Aloha Bowl here at Aloha Stadium. And Kansas will receive. UCLA won the toss. They deferred to the second half, so the Jayhawks will start with the ball first. And you look at the bowl records. Kansas 2-5. Won the Blue Bonnet Bowl in 61 and the Aloha Bowl here in 92. In fact, both of these schools have won this, trying to become the first team to win it twice.
Terry Donahue has participated in every bowl win UCLA has ever had, all 10 of them, either as a player, an assistant, or a head coach.
And for UCLA, this is how they arrived here in the Jeep Eagle Aloha Bowl. 7-4 overall, and you look at the struggles early on in the Pac-10. They lost to Oregon. They lost at Washington State. And then went on a winning streak The two losses late in the year, but a huge win over USC. 5 years in a row, they've beaten the Trojans.
In those early losses, UCLA had too many turnovers, 14 fumbles, 9 interceptions for the year, but they really struggled early on.
And Kansas had injuries early, as a matter of fact, but they won 7 in a row to open up. And then the two losses, Kansas State and Nebraska, and they didn't just lose those games, but look at the scores, 41-3 and 41-7.
Well, that Nebraska game is a little bit misleading. They actually outplayed Nebraska in the first half of that game, but made a couple of key mistakes, put the ball on the ground, gave the ball over to the easy touchdowns to Nebraska, cost them the game.
And Ashundé Smith back deep for the Jayhawks alongside Isaac Byrd and Greg Andrzejczyk from Honolulu will handle the kicking duties for UCLA, and he's been kicking a lot of field goals as of late for Bjorn Merton, who is the regular field goal kicker. They see him in action kicking field goals as well today. Slipped on the opening kick, and it's Smith inside his five. Looking for a seam and a good return out to the 27-yard line, and that's where the Jayhawks will start.
Their first series of downs, Ken Wokey. Defensive bat made the stop for UCLA. And Mark Williams, a very heady quarterback, a guy who's completed 70% of his passes in their Big 8 wins this year.
He's also the third-leading rusher on this team. We talked about his mobility and escapability, and that's going to be a factor today.
LT Levine leading the way in the backfield for Kansas, and two backs who've rushed for over 2,000 yards in their careers, and two wide receivers who have caught more than 40 passes this year. First time that's happened in Kansas history.
So first down, and here's the reverse. Smith looking for room. Not going to find much. He may have lost the yard. Got back to the 26, maybe the 27. Phillip Ward, the defensive end, made the stop. And the offensive line, Chris Banks, the all-Big 8 player, played the Aloha Bowl in 1992. Didn't expect to play. He's just here to get some sun. He said, all of a sudden, there's an injury. He had to go in the game.
Now, this group is not that big. Banks is very consistent. He's rated out higher than any lineman that Glenn Mason's ever had. And you look at the defensive line and the backers, these guys are quick. They've changed the scheme a little bit to get more quickness in there, and they've been able to do that.
Second and 11, play action. Williams with time. Out to his tight end, and Jim Moore. Across the 35, up to the 37-yard line, and close to a Kansas first down. Tommy Bennett made the stop. We check out the defensive backfield for the Bruins. Sean Williams, the second-leading tackler, had a knee injury against the Trojans in the last game of the year. They say he's 100%.
This defense has forced 25 turnovers. He's one of the reasons come off on the knee injury. I think, you get a game like this, it's a reward. All the players want to enjoy it. You have to watch the basics now. Kansas is offensively, they want to run him. Levine is just bouncing out and open things up with Williams. And defensively, they're going to overload on the run like they did against Kansas. They're going to come up, or against Nebraska, they're going to come up and they're going to jam that line, try to stop the run of the Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Third and one for the Jayhawks, just short of the 37. This is what Williams does well, rolling and gaining a first down to the 39-yard line. And Tim, we talked to the UCLA defensive coaches, and they said they are very worried about his mobility.
They've got him contained. There's no question about it. Flood control today is going to be paramount. That means the outside guys have come across the line of scrimmage, force him to stay inside that pocket or to run the ball tack.
So first down for the Jayhawks, and they're at the 40-yard line, just short of that. Henley and Levine in the backfield. Kansas will go with the one back set off. But here's Jordan Henley trying the left side, bouncing and stood up after a gain of maybe two. Sean Williams, the strong safety, made the stop first.
It's fun to watch Sean Williams. You talk about him being a safety, and yet he's a second-leading tackler because he commits and reads so early. Now, occasionally that'll cause him some problems. He may read too fast. He'll come up and commit, take the bite, boom, they run past him. But he's very, very effective, all-conference type guy.
Well, he saw this direction on the first play from scrimmage from Kansas. The reverse trying to hit them going against the grain.
Yeah, that play took a little bit too long to develop, though.
Second and at the 42. A lot of time for Williams in the room. And wide open is his tight end, Jose Andrade, at the 40-yard line of UCLA, no one near him.
I've got to tell you something. That's only his 13th reception of the year. But Glenn saw something, and again, there's Williams. Now watch how Williams buys his time. Already drops back, says he's got to keep him tackle. Look at him. He bounces outside. Now there's nobody out there. He's got plenty of time to throw. He just drops it over to Friday. Friday is not one of the key receivers. They weren't watched closely. Again, I tell you, it's only his 13th reception of the year, but a big play by Williams.
Gain of 18 on the play. They've used him a lot lately, though. He's had six catches in the last two games of the year. Here comes Levine. Nowhere to go. Wrapped up in the backfield. He's going to lose a couple. And there's that name again. Sean Williams got there first. We're calling him off and early, and probably well throughout the day.
Juan McGee with a nice play there, had a lot of pressure on Williams. But again, Bob Beal, the defensive coordinator of UCLA, said, hey, I expect Kansas to come out and just pound the ball, show that I-twins formation, and then run it. So they're loading up there. So I think the way to go for Williams here is to pass like he did Friday on fourth second and long. He's in a pass situation, short draw situation.
Loss of six on the play.
Williams, blocked out again. Open to Smith at the 34. And it loses yardage, actually, as he tries to get away.
Back just inside the 35-yard line.
Williams on the coverage. And the tackle, that's on a gain of 11.
Talking about Mark Williams, talking about his decision-making ability over the years, been very, very good. Again, they roll him this time to avoid the pressure. They take him to the outside. Look at the time he has. He reads three different receivers, goes through the progression, finds the open receiver outside, which is Smith, and just gets it to him and hits him right in the chest. Nicely done.
Okay, he completed 70% of his passes in Big 8 wins this year.
And
completed over 61% of his passes overall. It's a top mark in Kansas history.
The ninth play of the drive to Jayhawks. Over the middle of the beam. Bounces outside. Has a first down and more. To the 17, he is a big, strong running back. They like to throw the ball to their backs a lot.
Boy, again, Williams buys his time. Now watch this out of the shotgun. Go ahead and snap it. Now Williams looking again. He's looking to the right. All right, now he's going to go to a safety valve. Stop it right there. And you can see already, he's going out here. That's what he's looking for. He's looking for the open area to come out, find it, throw it underneath, under the linebackers. And look at this little shaking, big move on the linebacker, Donnie Edwards, who missed some time with an injury. He's not as sharp as probably was last year. And then they just bang way down to the big yardage.
And listen at 210. By the pool the other day, I'll tell you what. Straight ahead.
And a game of a couple of yards for LT Levine.
The Jayhawks are just outside the 15-yard line. Testing that defense to UCLA early on.
Well, Mark Williams, what a great story he is. Junior college transfer, Diablo Valley, look at what he's done when he gets down deep. They call this the red zone. They get inside the 20, flex call the green zone, the money area, the cash. This is what you want with the real deal.
Eric Albrecht now in for Levine. The quick draw to Smith at the 10-yard line. He catches it on his knee.
You know, again, Williams throws the dart. This is a guy, right out of high school, he spent 1 year working in a grocery store, just sacking groceries. He was recovering from an arm injury, actually had some surgery. They didn't think he'd be able to play college ball, so he sat out, worked in the grocery store, worked his way back to junior college, came in. Now he's playing great.
And he was referred to the Kansas now by the UCLA coaches. Didn't want to take that back at this point.
He actually wanted to go to UCLA, and they watched him as he grew up.
Third and three at the nine. Play action. To Moore. To the end zone. Touchdown, Kansas. They get on the board first.
How methodical was that? Glenn Mason says, I'm staying. They said, all right, coach, we're ready to play. Let's go out and get one for you. They used the tight ends in Kansas to play action pass guys. Here they drag him across the middle. Here's Jimmy Moore. Now this is his fourth touchdown of the year. This guy's 250 pounds. He uses that just to bull his way in. Touchdown, Kansas.
Jeff McCord on for the extra point, splits the uprights, and Kansas with a long drive early on. That started at their own 27-yard line. Mark Williams, 6-for-6 for 73 yards.
On the opening drive, and yeah, there's a little bit of emotion here.
Testing the new auto-stick system on the Eagle Vision is test pilot Captain Orlowski. You comfortable, sir?
I love the smell of your car in the morning.
I'll take that as a yes.
No clutch, easy to shift, no bulky oxygen mask, amazing control.
Even without the wings.
And that's okay.
Test it yourself. Make the call. 1-800-2-TEST-EAGLE.
We will be called private.
Anywhere. Washington, D.C. brought out that assault.
And the last drive of the game at Stanford
contest, a 98-yard drive to win the game, to secure the victory. And it was just Abdul-Jabbar right, left, and Ogden led the way the whole drive.
Let me tell you something, folks, about that guy on the screen, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. He is exciting, he's durable, he's talented, he's quick, he is an outstanding player.
Is that all?
And he averages 26 yards per carry, so he doesn't get tired.
Now, he had the bad ankle, and actually injured against Washington in this game against USC.
I got so excited, it's 26-yard carry. 26 carries a game. And he's going to be a problem with Glenn Mason.
The ankle does not look bad at all here. On their first drive, goes again to the left side. And it stopped maybe before he got the line of scrimmage. UCLA against the smaller defense in front of Kansas, and it's hot, it's humid, and we're playing on AstroTurf.
Yeah, but Terry, this defensive line is light, but very tall and strong and quick. They cause problems for quarterbacks already for UCLA, second and long.
James Milner now in the backfield for Abdul-Jabbar.
That's the height advantage right there. That's what I'm talking about. Houston is 6'4 and a half. He's got tremendous arm span. So even though he's light, he's only 245 pounds, that height and that timing causes problems for quarterbacks and bats down a lot of passes.
Houston, a former tight end, and his coaches love him, they say he'll put more weight work, and he's going to be an awfully good one. Watch this,
the freshman is locked onto the receiver right from the get-go, never looks off. Consequently, Houston knows where the ball is, he just times it, and bats it away where the big bear ball is.
Third and 11 for UCLA.
Big now to throw. Incomplete, overthrew the intended receiver, Brad Melsby, who was open for a moment, Jamie Harris. The right cornerback on the coverage.
Well, let's look at the ball game this way. Kansas has had the ball once, UCLA has had the ball once. So far, it's all Jayhawks.
I think sometimes emotion is overplayed as you look at Chris Saylor on the punt for UCLA, but you have to believe that in that locker room was quite a scene before the game.
Glenn Mason announcing to his team, shocking his team, the entire sports world, and especially the folks down in Athens, saying, hey, I'm committed to that job, but I'm not going, I'm staying here in Kansas.
Shundae Smith back at his own 13-yard line, waiting to slip punt. A high punt down at the 17-yard line. The fair catch by Smith, a punt of 38 yards, no return. Kansas is starting their second drive when we return.
People keep asking, how does it feel to be Steve Young?
Frankly, it hurts.
Give me my Advil.
Nothing has shown me that we're better at making muscles or proven that it lasts longer.
Advil is the one. For sore muscles, more doctors recommend Advil than any other pain reliever.
Nasty game.
Advil, advanced medicine for pain. The one store from the Sheraton Hotel they call Waikiki Beach Hall. The Sheraton Waikiki, the Royal Hawaiian. The Sheraton Princess Kailua. Let Sheraton turn the world's most famous beach into your own tropical paradise. Come celebrate Aloha with Sheraton. For reservations, call 1-800-STAY-ITT.
The Eagle Vision is the first sedan in the world with the auto stick system. Porsche offered their version in a coupe. This is German engineer Will compare.
So what do you think, good? This is good. I thank you for the money. Excellent. And we got that. What's he thinking? Good price. Thank you. Test yourself. Make the call. 1-800-TEST-EAGLE.
Monday is American troops moving to Bosnia. What Christmas is like for the families they left behind.
Start your Christmas day with Good Morning America.
Here on ABC.
ABC Sports coverage of the 1995 Eagle Aloha Bowl brought to you by Eagle Vision TSI, featuring revolutionary auto stick system.
Sheridan Hotels in Waikiki, celebration of Aloha. Burger King,
where you can get your burgers worth.
And the makers of Advil.
Looks like Rams riding one of those yesterday.
That's the Brand family right now. They said, I'm coming over there while Dad works. I'm going out and ride the waves.
Well, the announcement by Glenn Mason that he's staying, one of his assistant coaches, coordinator Golden Hat Rule. Of course, one of the men mentioned for that head coaching job with Mason leaving.
Isaac Burke with the catch at the 35 and the ball is loose.
We'll see if they blew the whistle. I believe they did.
Yeah, they're moving down. It'll still be Kansas ball now, 7 for 7. Interesting that you bring up Golden Rule. I had a long talk with him on the beach the other day. And he wants to be a head coach very badly. I thought he was going to get the opportunity here. He certainly had an interview scheduled when Mason did go to Georgia, but now that's not going to happen. So you wonder about his reaction. Certainly happy that Glenn stayed, his staff will stay intact. And he knew how important recruiting was, especially with the 11 guys that they wanted, that were ready to commit. But this is an opportunity at the same time, so I'm sure there's a mixed emotion.
First and 10, June Henley. Up to the 40, maybe the 41 after that late search.
Henley, a junior out of Columbus, Ohio, and kind of the foster brother of Ohio State's Terry Glenn.
Who lived with Henley's family, gets his name as a junior. And number five all-time rusher in Kansas history.
His real name is Charles. You know, the Ohio State's Terry Glenn, the 10th place receiver, moved in ahead of Henley years ago, just after Terry's mom murdered Glenn and Henley Lee Club.
Williams throws, Shundae Smith hit right at the 45-yard line. Made the catch near the first down, but Paul Guidry just smacked him to the ground. And they moved the chains, he got enough for the first.
Terry's still in the ballgame, but I can tell you this. I am surprised. Kansas is moving the ball with ease, very methodically. The game plan is solid. It's being executed. Glenn Mason has the team prepared. Obviously, they're motivated by what took place with Glenn saying he's going to stay. But Mark Williams has just been unbelievably sharp for an 85-yard touchdown and no picks.
Can't get any better. You know that UCLA expected Kansas to run the football and establish that with Henley.
And with Levine, they're throwing the football on every down.
This time they run Levine, stacked up the line of scrimmage, may have gained a yard.
See, now throwing the football doesn't surprise me, because if you're a football guy, you look at what UCLA is doing, they load seven guys up there sometimes to stop the run. If there are eight guys in that box, obviously you want to pass.
They're doing that, and they're doing it effectively.
So they're making the right choices offensively.
And throwing to their backs out of the backfield as well. Well, tonight is Action Monday on ABC, wrap up Christmas with a brand new episode of The Marshall, starring Jeff Fahey. And ABC's NFL Monday Night Football, the final game of the regular season, as Emmitt Smith and the Cowboys battle Arizona. And don't forget, all important, because Detroit lost 49ers yesterday, home field advantage tonight.
Talk about a Christmas present to the Cowboys with that 49ers loss. Boy, I mean, you know, he's got to rest some of those players, he's got to play. Now he's got to see these guys out there, they're really banged up, he's got to play, 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 he's got to play,
46. Williams under pressure this time. Throws to his back out of the backfield. To the 47 of UCLA, about 3 yards short of the first down. Williams with the coverage and the stop. And UCLA holds on this second drive of the Jayhawks.
Darren Simmons out for his first punt of the afternoon.
This is average on the year. And back deep, Paul Guidry.
Second team All-Pac 10 returner.
The end zone will go, and they'll bring it back out to the 20, 47-yard punt.
He wanted it to go about 45 yards.
UCLA taking over, now 7.
The throw to Kevin Jordan, and now again, Jordan throws his intended receiver. It's the second time that we have seen him do that. Powerless. Not a great. Once something happens to somebody else, I want to give you that. Much warmer than that now, and a lot warmer than that down in the astroturf. 38 of
one-yard line. And maybe gives UCLA a little bit of life.
Tom Robinson's crew here this afternoon.
Two people, Aloha ball.
Now, the 26-yard line.
From the blind side, Steve Brett got there first.
Well, you wonder about the reaction of Glenn Mason announcing at the beginning of the game that he's staying.
Speaking of blindsided, the players felt like that. And the emotion obviously used early in this game.
With the heat and everything else.
You mentioned that can stay in itself.
Now under pressure again.
And throws it right in the hands of Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
You know, before this game,
I think everybody expected that he was going to go to Georgia to make that announcement.
However, they've done it, 14 to nothing. Now, double covered up the 49-yard line and complete. Out of bounds, Dorian Brew actually made the interception. He was well out of bounds.
Watch Brew here, reads it, goes up, gets it inside his feet, don't come in, inbounds.
There's one, that's all he needs, that's an interception, that should have been a pick. I think he did, Brew had his fifth interception of the year, they aren't going to give credit for it.
Fourth and really long, 21.
Sailor almost blocked again, they've almost gotten to him twice.
Smith at his own 31. Down after a couple of yards on the return out to the 33-yard line.
I want you to watch his hands, Terry. Let's go back and watch Brew. You're saying, does he have possession? Number one, they've got double coverage. Dorian Brew reads it, plays inside out. Watch, he'll get the ball at a tight point. Now, as soon as he grabs it, he starts to tuck it away. Watch his hands. Here he goes. The ball's in his hands. He starts to tuck it away. Now, here comes his foot. He's got it. It's an interception.
You know, standing right there with a good look at whether or not he's got control.
I don't care where he is. I've got him set. Yes, he's got the pick.
But you can't tell if he had possession or bobbling at that point.
Well, I understand what you're saying. He doesn't have the advantage.
But he had a better angle.
He may pick.
What a great you are. He throws it away under pressure. The second today, he's thrown an incomplete pass.
Ball kicked aside, throws that pass. Could very well have been intercepted. I think the offensive coordinator said, hey, what Cade does. He's a freshman. Sometimes he tries to force the ball in there. Sometimes he takes sacks. He's got to learn not to do that.
Kansas offense, touchdown already by the offensive coordinator for UCLA, by the way, he's a granddad, his daughter Krista had a Christmas baby.
Nikki Alexander also, very Christmas. Congratulations.
Williams scrambling, throwing it away. And that was a good idea. No one open, he was going down one way or another.
I'm a big fan of his. I was at Texas A&M. When he was under Archie Slocum, I'm a big fan of UCLA. And I think if the folks at UCLA are looking for a five-head coach, you've got one right there. Bob Toledo doing an outstanding job as head coach. Cade McNown is quarterback, number 18 right there. I understand he's already going to see Dallas on Bob Toledo's behalf. And UCLA could do much better than that.
And a five-man, nice guy. Spent some time with him this week.
Straightforward, tell it like it is.
Third and ten for Kansas.
Out of the shotgun under pressure.
And again, Williams throws it away. Elvin Beam was there. But Weldon Ford. Got to Williams in a hurry.
Now Saturday on ABC Sports, it's an NFL wild card playoff doubleheader.
Matchups are set. Dolphins.
What a Buffalo to take on the Bills.
And then Detroit, Philly, and Eastern Standard Time, the way that Oakland started out this year, at 8-2, that they would make it Miami after struggling to dig Mid-season at the end, they would make it. The long season, not a damn thing, though. Nobody wants to get in the room, and knocked down at 22.
Kansas coming into this game, obviously,
Comes on for a field goal attempt of 43 yards. Hooking. And no good. Mert now tied at 17 on the year. Greg Andrews from Honolulu.
Another option for Terry Donahue, and we may see him later on today.
And another stop for Kansas. The Jayhawks on a roll with a stop, and they lead 14 to nothing.
I try. Denerix tingles. Denerix tingles.
Williams rolling out. Rose, 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 Rose
whether it's a homecoming game, or something important, college education. State Farm understands that. That's why State Farm makes sense. It's a smart way to help secure something ever happens. See your State Farm agent for life insurance, right for your family. It'll help make sure that all your children realize this.
Beginning January 8th, murder walks to Muncie's, and because great shows are rare. We'd like to take just a few minutes on January 8th and let us catch you up on what TV Guide calls the best new show of the year. We really think it's worth it. Stephen Botch's Murder Mondays at 10, starting January 8th on ABC. It's never too late to get caught up in murder.
132 left in the first half.
Here at the G Eagle Aloha Stadium.
Jeff Ford, the field goal kicker.
9 of 12.
Coming into this game on the year.
And they place it down at the 17-yard line.
27-yard attempt by Ford.
No question about it.
And no question about Kansas is coming today.
Boy, have they played well. Jay Hawks, the field defensively, pretty much having their way against the Bruins. UCLA came in as the favorite. Now the Bruins find themselves down 17-0. And we're almost a half to half. Everyone asked how they could be a five-point favorite when Kansas was ranked number 11.
So far, we found out a little bit about the standings.
This is how things went this year.
Stanford right there with UCLA. I thought Stanford would be in this bowl as back-to-back, but UCLA and the Bruins came.
Our producer Kim Dalton, very excited to see one of the all-time greats.
He'll tell you that. Him along with Bill Webber, director of the pictures today.
McElroy, five yards deep.
UCLA coming into this game, everyone's talking about leaving.
No, this first pass to Nate, to establish himself, to establish himself, to put in a drill player or two, and let that be the little boost back to back team, let him get excited.
Just under a half to go here. McElroy, the intended receiver, nowhere near him. The coverage by Dwayne Rooney, the all-big quarterback for the Jayhawks, and Cade McNamara is not the target today.
I think it's critical for Bob Toledo to do a little trick play, or get this UCLA team right now, the Bruins football. Stay tuned to us at halftime. Coming up.
Now the scramble.
field. Then down to the 40-yard line.
You've got 30 seconds left
here in the first half. They move the chains. The clock stops. Stop.
Get him up. He's got to get him up to the line. Get him going. To the sideline. He gets it. Now they're back. They're going to take a timeout.
Toledo wants to talk about on the sideline, and you had the feeling that UCLA may drop the clock after a couple of runs.
Now, of course,
you know you're going to score.
You'd like to say it's a good decision, but he's actually chased out of the pocket. He did his biggest, the most of a bad situation. Cade McDowell, he's going to be a talented freshman. You know, his mom loved to win, and she named him after a veteran soldier in the book, Cade. That's a strong name, Cade McDowell.
Of course, his dad is called Stud.
He's matured beyond his years. Just 18 years old.
Spent three years
off to California
at high school. His final year at West Wind. Up in Oregon.
Then, yes,
the Christmas trees are here in Hawaii, but
we didn't bring the ornament.
That was your job.
That was Dean Blevins' job, I believe. Dean Blevins' tree has done year-round work this bowl game, and actually 50 homeless children decorated the tree, and they are part of the wonderful job. Part of it. And Marsha and Lenny Collins do a wonderful job.
We agree with that. One of many things with this bowl game.
Williams does.
Clock ticks away.
puts an end to the first half of play.
Terry, now that you're trying to figure out what he can say at halftime examination,
certainly
very happy about what is taking place here in the first half.
That'd be very hard to play.
I think Terry's got to shake his guys up. He's got to put a fire on him. Loose a little bit in that locker room. Show some sort of emotion himself to get that ball. I think Glenn Mason says, hey, job well done.
And it's being Glenn Mason. He's with him down the field right now.
And I know, Dan, you're going to address the situation with Georgia, which we talked about earlier in the show.
What are your emotions at this point?
On the head,
How can I get a lot of money?
Aloha Stadium in Hawaii. Just dominant in the first half. They lead UCLA 17-0.
been a different flair all when you do spend the holidays here in Hawaii. You get a sense of Christmas.
The luau. The
luau.
Deal.
Certified, you can't at the freshman NCAA 1 or 2.
More information. Call 219-337-1492.
If you like the Jim and Jim, you lost the Bet Midgame.
Very brought a strength to the football program.
the guard who's a real
passion for the game.
Passion.
Sometimes I lose it.
Then carry the ball.
People around carry.
And that passion he has had for his end play, the decision to leave the UCLA after more decades, extremely difficult.
This has been my adult life, 25 years. And my wife and her in the whole time. Our children were born in that respect. And raised them. And so they really know. So for them, it's very, very emotional. Just like a book. And even though this was 4-1, I had to do what I knew.
UCLA will move on.
They won't fight.
The more information, contact the UCLA.
For more than 125 years, we have shared the excitement of those young men as they enter the field on Saturday afternoons. College football, USA. Committed to improving, promoting the great game. For those who play the game. For those who coach the game. For those who support the game. Brought to you by the American Football Association. The National Association of Collegiate Directors of Athletics. And their proud partners.
ABC Sports coverage of the 1995 Eagle Aloha, brought to you by Old Spice High Endurance
Deodorant. Long-lasting odor protection.
Now you've got proof.
Not Thomas.
Well, from this scene,
back to the mainland. Earlier on ABC Sports.
Go Tires Blu-ray All-Star Classic.
And right now, an update on Stars. Let's check in with Roger Twyba.
That's the 50th annual Kelly Tires Blu-ray All-Star Football Classic. At 43 yards, it's nothing but blue as they were in command. And it's yours today for the great team. Mr. Steve Jansen, he showed terrific movement. Moving up, 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 moving
It's really that simple. Just incidental.
Not flagrant at all. Just 5 yards. Actually, good play. Good play by Will because he was up in the
track. Reached out. Tried to grab anything.
Now you want to
control the ball the whole way.
Once he got past, he realized he couldn't.
Tucked it under and ran.
First down.
At the 36.
Williams
on the roll.
Incomplete. Almost picked off.
Really the first pass that we've seen him throw into coverage.
Ill-advised pass.
Bennett was there.
See the first start at 28.
On that drive, Williams was six for six.
Then they came out, made some adjustments.
They made a stop.
They were loading up to stop the pass.
Backed off.
That's when they made an adjustment.
The throw became very effective.
49-yard run.
Teamed up.
UCLA would hit him.
June Henley had 49-yard
touchdown run.
Second and one. Mark Williams playing the line.
Going up.
Top receiver in the end zone, complete.
Paul Guidry was there step for step.
Ryan Foyt, the receiver.
Guidry may have sprained an ankle on that play, came up a little bit.
Well, I tell you what, he's going to get the shit, except for the accounting. Shoulder and shoulder. Good cover guy. Mason Butler was a little bit of a grinding. It was not a bad call. Second and one. You try to go to the end zone. Take that shot. Come back and get the first down. Williams on the roll.
Got a first down inside the 24-yard line. Option to run. Runs the option well. This is the guy who we talked about at the top of the game.
UCLA very concerned about his mobility.
That's the first time that we've seen the option all afternoon.
They worked it effectively. UCLA really off balance. The defense is playing on its heels.
Jayhawks, some sun here.
Henley bounces.
And wrapped up at the 18-yard line.
Needs to get to the 14 for a first down.
Made the stop.
Mix it in there right now. UCLA can't afford to be aggressive. They don't know because they don't know what's going to be.
Tell you something, Henley is the slash, the power guy. He's only 5'10", but he's 210 pounds. Not for a second, right here in Hawaii.
Carried the ball six times, six yards.
They beat BYU.
He's had a tremendous season, came with 860 yards, 1,000 for his career.
For the reason, Mason Lyson, from his hometown.
In a 14-14 run, first, looking for the room, slips inside the game, one down to the three.
This reminds me of the old SMU, Eric Dickerson, and our guy.
Great James.
Now Terry Donahue making that decision. We heard it at halftime. 4-1, Bo and his family.
Four against one. There's his family, and he had to decide.
His wife, his daughter. Merry Christmas to Donnie. Happy holidays, and our best.
Even though they're out voting.
Straight ahead to the end zone.
And Kansas, four on the board.
Boy, they have been impressive.
June Henley had a touchdown this time.
Only from three yards out.
Don't let this leak out. Terry White is a KU grad.
Tom Glenn Mason at the other night said,
They were talking, and she
said she was going to root for KU,
and it was a loud call from the UCLA side.
Watch this offensive line.
Fire out again. What do they do to this defense?
Go ahead, snap. Here comes Williams.
Goes to his horse.
They're knocking guys out of there.
Just spin him. 77 was spun.
The extra, no good.
Take this drive and get down into the end zone, at least get a field goal out of this thing. Brett McGraw was there first.
Well,
It's good looking.
They can't sing.
They
Sunday Smith is running back out to the 20-yard line. You see the wet towel on the sideline, but more light on the sideline for UCLA. Very down to Hugh,
Alito,
getting going here in the second half,
drive.
And the 8-yard touchdown pass to Melvin.
UCLA big strong lineman trying to cool down.
Over near the fans, they've got ice on their backs, necks, heads.
Terry Donahue,
talking about what's happening offensively.
Got a long way to go,
slowly,
back into it.
First down, first down, will now try to establish.
Part of their running game once again.
So dominant with the passing game early on
in the contest.
Went back to the running game.
It's a warm afternoon in this AstroTurf.
We started today. 81 degrees in local time. That was 10:30 or so.
To this point, Kansas has been nearly flawless offensively.
Look at the difference.
Williams on the roll.
Going deep.
To Bird.
Through his hand.
Step for step.
John Williams.
On the coverage.
I want to tell you, Bird's covered. They got Twin receivers out here. Watch number one. Here's Lawrence. He's got excellent coverage. Makes the pick. Well, that's as good as it goes. Here's Lawrence. Let him go. Listen to the safety. Now, Bird thinks he's open. But here comes Williams. Who's got the ball all the way. Everybody's eyes are on the offensive receiver when he straight to the ball.
Good D, that time. Covering the man who made the catch. Bird, they spin. First time it's ever happened in Kansas history.
Going deep again, Bird.
It had to.
ABC Sports coverage of 1995 G5
by Eagle Vision. Eagle Vision. Featuring the revolutionary auto stick system.
And Budweiser,
official sponsor of the 1996
U.S. Olympics team. This Bud's for you.
Look at Waikiki Beach.
And
record-setting
Isaac Burke.
August
ball pass
for touchdown.
Kansas history.
And the Aloha Bowl.
Record as well.
Longest pass in the Aloha Bowl.
77 yards.
Bird and Tip
just took the air right on the sideline.
UCLA.
They had some juice going a little bit.
Some momentum in them.
And just turned it around.
Obviously can't be the celebration.
No.
Outside. I'll bend it inside the 30 down to the 27-yard line.
leg. Take out his leg.
You know, defensively,
we mentioned earlier Donnie Edwards, the year that he had a disappointment for last year, had a terrific year, injuries this year, you watch him pursue.
Yeah, he had the vertebrae
Yeah, the 49ers lost.
Cowboys down.
Cowboys down.
For that home field.
This is huge.
47-yard line.
Aloha Bowl.
Kansas, with things well in at this point.
back with more between the Jayhawks and the Bruins. After this message and a word from our ABC station.
Just takes it and pancakes. That is a dominating tackle. He tells the guy, tells the opponent. drive the receiver at the goal line.
For a moment, like Derek Ayers,
Harris.
You know, Terry, you worry about these guys in the future.
I think Jordan, after they lost, got it back. Jordan at least has a piece of it.
It is UCLA.
Question.
The ball down to the goal line,
and no question,
when you go for two.
when they got it. Two when they got it.
He took his jersey out.
Ruled it dead.
Little breakdown defense there, last hand there, last first down. UCLA wishful thinking, thought the ball was popped down. The decisions were very impact, We can't find a better one team punter anywhere in the country.
LT Levine.
Henley 76 yards.
LT Levine,
841.
Rush for over a yard.
And it was a bit of a problem at the start of the season.
Mason wanted to go
to the passing game.
You got these two very good backs.
Utilizing one back.
Throwing the ball for them as well.
Williams still looking.
Up to the six yard line.
I'm telling you, he is special. He has been fun to watch this afternoon.
It hurts in so many ways.
Talk about containment all day. UCLA is unable.
Kelly Tyres.
All-star game earlier today. 26-27. UCLA comes back here.
That'll bring up third down. UCLA has to make this stop.
They can't let them get a first down.
Pretty much over.
Henley with 103 yards on the afternoon.
We saw early on.
The passing game established by Kansas.
Now a big third down for the Jayhawks.
Here come the Bruins.
The quick out across midfield and down to the 47 yard line.
UCLA.
What a big play.
Clock continues to move down, stop the chains.
But very methodical drive right now.
Not a bad month. Qualifies you for residence.
Couple more years, come back to the Pro Bowl.
Emotional day on both sides of the football in separate ways.
After the line of scrimmage, that's about it.
There are LT Levine.
This is an impressive drive that's going off right now.
Everything that took place before was a great win.
This right here is sealing the victory.
quick strikes by UCLA to get back in it.
Jabbar and the catch.
That's short of the first down.
probably will not probably return. Will not return.
UCLA takes a UCLA time takes out. A timeout. That means they have two left. They have two left. Left. Two left. One left. 6 minutes more. 6 minutes more. Bruins down by Bruins down by 15.
5:58 left. There we go. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo.
Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo.
Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo.
Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo. Bob Toledo.
Don't forget, later on, later on.
ABC's NFL, ABC's NFL.
Monday night, football, the Cowboys,
deserve break.
Well deserved break.
They changed the car.
That's not a stupid question.
I know it is.
saying that belongs.
You don't say that belongs.
I'm not funny. I'm not funny. I'm not funny. I'm not funny.
Brown.
Made the hit.
Oh, I don't
Let's show the road to the famous beat band of your own tropical flavor. Come, Waking up, ball, waking up, ball.
Right here in Honolulu.
Right here in Honolulu.
And ABC's
ABC's three games.
That will
certainly be
great one.
Great matchup.
Great matchup.
Touchdown.
three.
Blows down, blows
at
down.
About the 25-yard line.
And came
and
up just short.
Yeah, but I'll tell you something.
Javelin Gibbery
had two angles,
but Van knew it.
So he changed his angle and went right to the pylon.
Now watch this.
First of all, watch this.
All right, now he sees.
All right, now he sees.
Pursuit pull. Let's cut back.
Valuable players of the game. Rematch with Jabbar from UCLA.
And Mark Lynch from
Williams from Bill DeMarco.
152 yards
in the afternoon, and Mark Williams is Mark 28 yards, 8 passing touchdowns, and one rushing touchdown. The check of the amount of $1,000 by the Eagle, by two Eagle School General Scholarship Fund, scholarship fund,
qualified students,
advancing educational goals.
He's been a constant.
As time went down,
Never had more fun.
Thank you, Jim.
Thank you, you and your family.
Let's do it again.
Walker with the timeout.
Right here with me. Drop that hint.
Not a bad way to spend your holidays.
Under a minute left.
Well, the game for 57 seconds left.
I'm not sure why we're taking it. Great job by Glenn Bates and his team for this.
I'm ready for the bowl game.
Then making it to his team prior to kickoff, and he's going to stay.
Lawrence did not go to Georgia.
He's done a terrific job.
That's time for the Dallas. I think so.
He's looking back.
He still has equipment.
Here it comes.
Oh, yeah.
You know what, though?
It's not bad when it's 85 degrees.
You know what it's like, minus 10 in Buffalo. Bring it on.
Great day for him. Nice job wherever he is.
Walker.
Under thrown. Tended receiver.
A big afternoon in the second half.
For the Bruin players too.
We talked about it throughout the week here in Honolulu, wanting to sing, fitting manner.
It's not going to happen.
An outstanding career, back in wins in any coaching history.
Glenn Mason.
Well, as of right now, he's staying at Kansas.
The announcement before the game to his team.
That he was the head coach of the Kansas Jayhawks.
Saying goodbye to Terry Donahue, leaving you 20 years as the head coach of the Bruins.
send you down to the field. Down to the field. Dean Blevins, right now.
Easier than you thought. Easier than you feel about.
What do you feel about?
Well, you're not. Well, you know, any football team, Dean, that will go. Dean, that will go
this year with 10.
This year with 10 victories.
And we're one of them.
And we can take it away from us.
I think no one gave us a chance.
The Plains State,
Big Eight Country.
They had us down and out.
And I got a young
team here, and
we might be short on talent.
We're long on character.
We got the right chemistry.
If you got chemistry, I don't have to buy it.
We got it.
And you got to do everything you possibly can to make sure that you don't give it up.
Lend your people back in Kansas.
Verify the story we had
earlier that you decided to stay in Kansas.
Why are you staying in Kansas? That's committing to Georgia.
Well, Dean, first of all, I want to apologize.
I want to apologize
to people of Georgia.
Coach Vince Dooley,
I know I put them in a very embarrassing situation.
That's not my style.
It really comes down to
personal reasons.
The short of it is that right now, in
1995, the best thing for me,
best thing for my family, especially
maybe the best thing,
maybe the best thing for my career is to stay in Kansas.
And I had to shift here. I profoundly apologize and
beg forgiveness.
Good luck the rest of the way.
Congratulations on the big day.
Thank you, Dean.
Right, guys.
Very honest moment.
Not only first the week,
Kansas, but then
Kansas. 8-track player and cartridge of
your boots. This is nice.